Hello, beautiful people. I just wanted to share a little bit of wisdom to you about setting up your own sacred temple space. So I've just recorded a series of videos for Roop and my first ever teacher training program called the Energy Medicine Practitioner Training, Level One. And I'm really inspired to share with you a little bit of a snippet from one of the videos that I did. So I was talking about the importance of or how and how we create and set up a sacred ceremonial space. So this is so important because, the world can be a very busy, intense place. And I love to come back and retreat, relax in my sanctuary to my temple. And in my temple, I've created and cultivated the energies exactly how I like them to be and exactly how I want them. And you can do the same thing too. And that space can be a place for you to also create boundaries for other people to engage and interact with that space. So if you are looking for somewhere that's just for you, where you can do your morning practice or meditate or read or just be with candlelight in meditation or in devotion. That's why it's so important to have this sacred ceremonial space. And it's okay to have boundaries around that. It's okay to ask your children to play around and to, not get entangled with your sacred things. Another important aspect of creating sacred space is to have your own temple. And in this temple, you can keep all of the sacred things to you, symbology. You can have your deities or archetypes. Perhaps you have an altar where you offer the elements every morning. You burn a candle to honor the fire. Maybe within your altar space, you put place photos and prayers for loved ones. It's completely up to you. There's no right or wrong way to create an altar or create your temple. It's all about cultivating a space that is empowered and encoded with your energies and your intentions, where you feel that you can retreat and create the stillness that you need, that you desire, that you long for after a really long day working, being in service to others. So I recommend and encourage you to take a look at your sacred space. Do you have one and maybe it needs a little bit of love or a bit of tweaking and upgrading to really, include and be enlivened with everything that you feel that you desire and you need? Perhaps you don't have a sacred space and now is the time to create one. If you want any more advice or guidance on any of this, please get in touch. I would love to also share with you my sacred spaces, what they look like, and how I cultivate the energies in those spaces. Have a beautiful day.